right, let's talk about Bud versus Canelo Alvarez. Canelo Alvarez versus Terrence Crawford in the aftermath of Charlo losing and getting dominated by Canelo Alvarez. Now, some people still silly willy dilly enough to believe that Terrence Crawford can win. Y'all seen Jermell Charlo, who's a physical specimen, by the way, move up two weight classes and can do nothing with Canelo. Weight classes matter. These are not just for recreational use. There's a reason why they put the dividers in weight classes, and those bridger weights in weight classes like super and juniors and all that, and lights and all that stuff. It's in there for a reason, like Earth, Wind, and Fire say. The reasons that we hear, the reasons that we hear, dun, 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 whatever they said. And it's a reason for that. You know what I'm saying? There's a super duper reason for that. So Bud can't like really do nothing with that, bro. Like, can he give a better effort than Charlo? Yeah, but you know, everybody say, man, you know, everybody sit here and say how they'll go out on their shield. Man, Wilder, one of the few fighters, I agree with Malik Scott. Wilder, one of the few fighters that literally said he wanted to go out on the shield, and he lived what he rapped. So you gotta respect that. You know, and my whole thing about it is, it's just too much weight. And you know, Terrence Crawford criticized Jermell Charlo, said he went in there and laid down, came for a check, and he can probably insinuate that, you know what, I go out on my shield, but it sound good. But the minute, you know, you start milling it in, you start going to survival mode, then people gonna call a spade, but you know, Bud don't strike me as a guy that wouldn't go out on the shield. But it's too much weight, man. After that performance, it, you know, I didn't need to be confirmed on my end. I already know what it's about. It's a reason not too many people jump up three weight classes, especially with a guy that's already up three or four rounds before you step up in the ring. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, just because people say, well, just because Jermell couldn't put the weight on the right way don't mean Terrence can't put the weight on. Hey, You're right. And people thought before the fight that Terrence was a better fighter and this, that, and the third. And that might not change nobody's opinion and blah, blah, blah. And, you know, it is what it is. But in my humble opinion, bro, Canelo's just too big, bro. Too big, too powerful. Do Terrence Crawford possess the utensils to go do what he needs to do? Absolutely. Yes, I said utensils. He possessed the jab, the speed, the foot movement. He more skilled than Jermell Charlo. But overall, man, that natural size is a problem. That natural size is a problem. You know, it's why Canelo ain't giving nobody nothing. It's the reason why Canelo ain't giving nobody nothing. He ain't giving you a pound. He ain't giving you a rehydration clause. You know, none of that. You know, he ain't giving. There's a reason for that. He's very insecure, especially when it comes to fighting black fighters. You know, especially after that. You know. So. Especially after that. Especially after that. So. But it don't change my opinion. It's just too much weight. Simple as that. Just too much weight. And to me, it's another money grab. And I like Crawford. Got a lot of love from my favorite fighters going right now. But I'm always tell the truth. It's about money. The way he changed his opinion within a week about fighting, you know, Canelo and what weight he was going to fight Canelo at, that told me everything I need to know. It's a money grab. Now, I don't mean he ain't going to go up there and give his best effort, but guess what? You know, instead of Al Haymon making the fights that we want to see as fans, he keep giving us a whole bunch of money grabs. you know, a whole bunch of fights where, you know, that's the new thing in boxing, to give us fights for guys moving up to avoid certain competition, or move up just to move up for more victory or for a bag. Just start making the fights people want to see on time and see where that go in the sport of boxing. Start matchmaking your guys tougher and see where that go in the sport of boxing. You know, I don't have a need to see this fight. Nobody did, you know, nobody have a need to see this fight. Nobody want to see this fight. If Crawford go up there and be great and beat him, then it's a spectacle of a fight. If he competitive in there and it's close, I mean, it's a great fight. But this ain't the fight. Don't nobody in boxing ask for this bullshit. Go fight David Benavidez. That's what people want to see. That's what people want to see. You fight David Benavidez. That's what people want to see. You know? But no, I don't, you know, if anything, you know, I already knew what I knew. I didn't need to see him beat up on Charlo to already know what was going to happen. I didn't need to see that. A lot of y'all just be so thirsty for good boxing. We be so deprived for good boxing that y'all be just looking for reasons for dudes to win. Y'all try to look at the glass half empty all the time. Y'all just be looking for reasons for dudes to win. Even if it ain't no real tangible reason there or intangible reason there. Y'all just be looking for dudes to, y'all be looking for it. Knowing that the interest not there. Y'all be, oh, yeah, but he could do this, he do that. I'm going to go for him because he black and all that. Okay, it's fine. I don't mind people rooting for people for ethnic pride, but let's keep it real. Let's keep it real. But when you betting with your money, or you want to sound intelligent, or all you gotta say is like, "Yo, yeah, I agree with you saying," or "I believe Canelo gonna." I can see why your people say Canelo gonna win. Blase this, blase that. But you know what? I'm riding with Charlo. I think Canelo gonna win, but I'm riding with Charlo. That's fine. Can't nobody knock that. Well, I see what you're saying, CJ, but I'm going to ride with Canelo to win. Or I'm going to ride with Charlo to win. Cool. Cool. I got to respect that, bro. I tell you all the time, you know, let's say Wilder fighting Fury, man. I want Wilder to win. But, you know, I think Fury going to win. If I'm pulling for Wilder, that's fine. Ain't nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that. Trust and believe me. There's nothing wrong with that. But, nah, man, I hope y'all seen last night. Ain't no way that man could beat him under those circumstances. Ain't no way. And if he beat him, he one of the 5 or 10 greatest fighters I've seen in my lifetime. Flat out. Flat out, but I'm not paying for it. Oh no, I'm not paying for that ass whooping, my boy. I'm not paying for it. Flat out. I'm tired of giving Al Haymon, you know, Al Haymon getting money grabs instead of doing the right thing. Now, he want to do a few money grabs while doing the right thing. I respect it. You know what I'm saying? I respect it. But give us some prime fights, bro. That's all we asking for. Give us some prime fights. You can put your bullshit in there a little bit. Cool. We can respect that, but I mean, it is what it is. But yeah, my stance don't change. It's an easy fight for Canelo. Too much weight. And this ain't no knock on Bud at all. Hell of a fighter. Hell of a fighter. But that's just too much to ask for him to go up and do that. Too much. Too much. Too much. You know, we want to see a competitive fight like we got with, or we will get with Benavidez and Andrade winner. That's what we want to see. Bud can go rematch Earl and do what else he want to do, walk away from the sport if his money right, Hall of Famer, you know, but I think, you know, this is my opinion from looking at on the outside, looking in. I feel like it's a money grab. And that's my opinion. I feel it's a money grab. His opinion changed too fast about not wanting to fight Canelo at 68. Now Heyman called him and told him how much he can make. He like, word? Come on. He told Canelo how much you gonna make. And Canelo is assuming all the public risks. And Crawford is assuming all the risks in the ring. Physically. But it just like somebody selling AO. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. So let me know what you girls and guys think, man. Thumbs up the video. Share the video. Subscribe to the channel. Next subscribe button is the bell icon button. Hit all notifications. Increase your chance. Get notifications. We go live or drop video. Financially, want to support the channel. Cash App, $CJGood313. Venmo, CJGood313. PayPal link in description. Hit the link tree. Find me on Twitter, Instagram, Spotify, Anchor, Cash App, Venmo, PayPal, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, the whole nine. Appreciate the love and support. Let me know what you girls and guys think in the comment section. You know. But other than that, man, I appreciate y'all for supporting the channel. Check out the boxing. Well, it ain't even the boxing playlist. Ain't gonna be no playlist for this. But hey, don't forget, check out my new channel right here on YouTube, Free Game 89, FR33 Game 89. Also, check out my Detroit channel, Mercy Sports Talk. All that's in the link tree or in the comments or in the description. Peace.